This is the video review for the Doctor Who 11 Doctors set. Having seen the pictures, you'll see how detailed this figure is. This figure is very nicely detailed. Got a nice black jacket, grey trousers, black shoes, nice little walking stick that he holds. Got a ring on each hand. Very nicely detailed articulation. It can go side to side. It may do 360, but I'm not going to force it. Arms 360 at the shoulder, swivel at the biceps and elbow movement, wrists rotate 360, waist can go. But I wouldn't do that very often. Legs go forward. Well, not so much back. They go forward, in and out. Rotating the thighs and bend at the knee, which is very good articulation for a figure like this. Doctor number 2, Patrick Troughton. Very nicely detailed. As you can see, this figure is also very nicely detailed, as are all the figures. He has his little handkerchief in the pocket, in his pocket. Nice little bow tie. Grey, almost checked trousers. Not that you'll be able to see them here, but probably not. Toes and nice shoes, and he has his little recorder, which is a nice touch. Put that back in his hand. Articulation wise, head goes slightly side to side, but not much. Arms, again, standard 360. In and out, and up and down at the elbow. Wrist turns, waist turns, legs forward, in and out, not much. Tate at the thigh, bend at the knee. And that's, don't drop him, and that's how he is. Third Doctor, John Pertwee, very nice detailed figure. Just pictures. This figure, this was the first Doctor to have a sonic screwdriver. Have a very nice one with the yellows and the red, the blacks. Now this figure of the Doctor, one thing that makes me like it over many of the other figures is that he has a removable cloak, so let's just take it away.
Now
been painted very nicely with a bright orange on the inside. And then without the jacket you get more articulation out of the figure. Head sadly doesn't turn, but that doesn't bother me that much. Arms, same again. 60 in and out, bend at the elbows. Wrists turn, waist turn, forward, in and out, rotate at the knee, thigh, bend at the knee. And there's John. Nice update of the previous figures. I myself don't have the Pyramids of Mars Tom, sadly. Now, if you've seen on the all previous Fourth Doctor figures that the Sirius face has never had a hat before, on this first figure to do so, and the head on this figure is swappable, although I wouldn't do it that often. Articulation, head rotates slightly, hindered by the scarf. Arms rotate 360, in and out, bend at the elbow. Wrist, waist, legs in and out, forward, rotate, thigh, bend at the knee, and overall very nice figure. Fifth Doctor Peter Davison. Should really be seeing how he is, shouldn't I? Oh well, too late for that. This figure, nice update from the previous Classics Wave 1 Fifth Doctor. You can see he finally have a mass market released version with a stick of celery. Apart from that, this figure is exactly the same as the previous one. Head can rotate 300, well, side to side, but wouldn't want to force it. And then arms, the same again as all the other figures. Legs, all the same. And he's got his nice little sonic screwdriver, same as the previous release. And there we go. Sixth Doctor Colin Baker, very nice figure, and it's nice to see that they've changed it so much since the, it's nice to see that they've changed it so much from the first release, otherwise I'll go through the colour differences, and this Doctor is the only one from the set that doesn't have an accessory, doesn't have his arms. Not sure why. Trousers are the same colour. His red is slightly deeper, would you say? Don't know. He's got a brighter red on the inner side of his sleeve, less No, I think it's the same amount of stripes on this arm. There's too many colour differences on there. Nice yellow, spotty cravat, whereas before it was blue. Nice, bright, stripy waistcoat. Shade of yellow is different. Much darker pink, as is on the sleeve. Oh, some pictures. Different greens, different reds, totally different colour pocket. Totally different colour bit on the back. No black stripes going down. And slightly lighter. Overall, it hasn't got that that almost grubby look to it. It looks cleaner than the old one. And the hair, you probably won't spot any difference. This one's slightly lighter. And the other head sculpt's the same. And that's all for Mr. Colin. I'm going to stop there for now because I'm running out of time, and I'll continue in a second part. So that's all for now.